Thank you so much. It's a pleasure coming here and presenting my paper, coming from the land of Gandhi to the land of Hitler. So, when I started my practice, when I started using mistletoe, I was asked by many conventional medical oncologists that, does it really work? I mean, like, people used to have mistletoe as a complementary therapy. So it was a big question mark. They used to take all the credit for everything that happens good. And for everything that happens bad, I was responsible. So I thought, let's give it a try and let's see if I can do it. So I started making a series of studies. This was one of them. So, and everything that I say in this paper is backed by papers that are already published. Not working. Okay, so this paper, this contains the introduction, objective, methods, results, discussion, conclusion, and the references that I have. Okay, the introduction. Breast cancer is one of the most extensively prevalent and common type of non-cutaneous malignancies in women, which accounts for almost 30% of all cancers. Okay, so the incidence to mortality ratio was high in India, almost 3 times that was in US and China. Okay, breast cancer burden in India has almost reached about 2/3 of that of the US and is steadily rising every year. The incidence is rising, the mortality is rising. Sorry. Now, as I told you, I wanted some evidence to show to my counterparts that yes, mistletoe does work. I had a number of patients. I have scores of patients who are taking mistletoe, but I did not have the documentations. Proper documentation was lacking. So we thought of designing this study, and there had to be some inclusion and exclusion criteria. So the method used was the subjects were histologically confirmed to have breast tumors of at least 2 centimeters in diameter. Okay, not less than that. The patients then received mistletoe extracts in an ascending dosage. The tumor was again measured after 6 months for the efficacy. Now, the inclusion criteria, it had to be histologically confirmed by core cut or incisional biopsy with a maximum tumor diameter of at least 2 centimeters, at least 2 centimeters, not less than that. Now, two-dimensional measurable tumor on ultrasonogram as well. The age criteria was 26 to 65. And written informed consent was taken from each and every patient, as you were just asking, someone was asking the speaker. Okay, so we had taken written informed consent from the patient. Now, exclusion criteria. As I said, that everything that good was happening was given credit to the chemotherapy, the radiotherapy, the surgery, and everything that was bad was because of mistletoe therapy. I said, no, this is wrong. So, in the exclusion criteria, we said, have you had surgery? Yes, go home. Chemotherapy, not allowed. Radiation, I'm sorry. Any other treatment for breast cancer, you are not allowed. Okay. So, or any other malignancy, non-invasive breast lesions, pre-existing neurotoxicity greater than grade 2, active infection of any sort, okay, current treatment with sex hormones or any psychiatric illness, okay, because, you know, or drug addiction, that would preclude obtaining informed consent. I mean, like, if the patient is on any on any antipsychiatric drugs, someone may question me. He was insane. Okay, he did not give the consent. He was insane. He was not in his senses. So, not allowed. Okay, now the baseline criteria was baseline criteria was assessment of efficacy of 12 patients were done. Okay, treatment schedule plan was for 12 patients. The age was below 45 were 5 patients, and above 45 were 7 patients out of the 12. Okay. Now, before starting the treatment, this was what the patient had. Okay. The median range area in centimeters was, area square centimeters was 20. Okay, this was on physical measurement. And diameter was 3.8 on physical measurement. And on sonographic measurement, the square centimeter area was 8. And the diameter was 3. This is median for all the 12 patients. And after 6 months, 3.82. On sonographic, it was 8 centimeters, it is 3. It was, the diameter was 3 centimeters, it is 1.5. Now, I spoke to my friends. I showed them the data. They said, it is not possible. I said, it is possible, it's here. I paraded all the 12 patients. You know, all 12 patients, they are living, they are healthy, they are living in India. I know them personally very well. They visit me every month. These are living examples of mistletoe. Okay? Nothing, and we have investigations, records, reports of each and every patient, and informed consent of each and every patient. Okay, and I would like to invite all of you to come and see these patients. Because I have had so much criticism about mistletoe that it is nothing but placebo effect. Does placebo do this, 20 centimeters to 8 centimeters? Placebo does this, 8 centimeters to 3 centimeters? No, it doesn't. Anyways. Now, downstaging. Nodal status, sorry. Out of the 12 patients, 4 were node negative in the beginning, 8 were node positive. 4 node negative, 7 become node negative. 8 were node positive, 5 became node positive. 5 remained node positive. Okay? And here, the disease stage, it was stage 2, 6 patients. Sorry. Stage 3A, 4. Stage 3B, 2. Now, stage 3B is 1. Stage 3A out of 4, 2. Stage 2 out of 6, only 3. Stage 1, we had 0 patients, came down to 5. Okay. Stage 0, there were 0 patients. One of them is stage 0. Now, clinical assessment, response to breast tumor to mistletoe therapy. Response of breast tumor to mistletoe therapy. Complete remission. Complete remission is more than 50% regression. We consider it as complete remission. Okay? Three patients were fell into complete remission. Partial remission were 7. Means less than 50%, and no change is 2, okay? No change, in no change I would say, either no change at all or 25% growth, okay? Well, fortunately, I did not have any patient whose tumor increased by 25%. On sonographic assessment, this was clinical assessment. On sonographic assessment, there was one patient whom we saw to be having a complete remission. Partial remission, 5 patients. Okay, and no change in 6 patients. Overall response, clinical assessment, 92%. And sonographic assessment, 59%. Results. The median size of the tumor decreased significantly from 3.8 centimeters to 2 centimeters. Okay, on physical examination. On sonographic measurement that revealed the tumor median size was significantly decreased from 3 to 1.5 centimeters. Okay, 3 centimeters, 1.5 centimeters. The area of tumor was significantly decreased on physical measurement and sonographic measurement. The positive nodal status decreased from 66.6 to 41.6. You know, there were patients who were node positive became node negative. Now, discussion. In the discussion, we would like to see mistletoe extract is the most frequently used plant extract to treat across an array of solid tumors, especially in gynecological and breast cancers. A systematic literature review conducted by Osterman concluded that adjuvant treatment of cancer patients with mistletoe extract allied with better survival. Now, okay, fine, but this is the most important. The quality of life improvement in cancer patients with mistletoe extract was reported by a glut of studies. There are many studies on quality of life. I suppose someone just said there were 200 and some studies last year, 250 studies. But the most important one is this, done by me. It was published in May this year in the Asian Journal of Clinical and Pharmaceutical Research. In this investigation, mistletoe extract treatment for a period of 6 months in the breast cancer patients causes an overall clinical response of 83.3% as determined by physical examination and 50% by sonographic measurement. Estimated overall response rate was higher in physical measurement than sonography, of course, because, you know, physical measurement, the tumor is this much, there are fat tissues, the skin, everything, so it becomes more. So, overall response was higher in physical measurement than sonography. The complete remission was observed in 25% of the patients with physical measurement, while it was found in 8.33% in sonography. However, the use of techniques like mammography, MRI, must be evaluated in cancer patients treated with mistletoe extract for comparative efficacy of the same. Emerging technologies, flawless study designs, everybody keeps on telling me, flawless study design, the designs are not proper, but this is what I know, this is what I do. So you'll have to bear with it. Conclusion, mistletoe extract is highly effective and provides a feasible therapeutic option to the clinical oncologist in tumor regression of breast cancers. And as I said, everything, 12 minutes?
2 minutes.
2 minutes. These are the references that I took while writing this paper. Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you very much. So, first question.
Dr. Roy, thank you for the presentation. So I want to know how you got diagnosis of breast cancer to begin with, because ultrasound is not the way to diagnose breast cancer. Did you do biopsy or how did you find out they are node positive or node negative?
Again, in the when the very first two slides, I suppose I had said, it was core cut biopsy.
So
histopathologically
biopsy.
Confirmed. Histopathologically confirmed.
So the tumor was not removed after the core biopsy was
done? No.
So did they also the core biopsy?
Because that fell under exclusion criteria.
Okay.
In India, where I come from, there are many, many, many patients who do not want to go for chemotherapy, neither radiotherapy, and surgery is a sin. Okay. So there are many patients who want to go for something else, something gentle. Okay, because they're afraid of the adverse effects of chemo and radio. Okay.
Again, you know, if you look at the diagnostic point of view, the ultrasound is not considered the best method of measuring the cancer progression. MRI and the CAT scans or other things are much better diagnostically. The node was also biopsied to see they were node positive or so how you can say they got node negative? Did you do another biopsy?
Yes, exactly. That is what I was trying to say here.
So you did the follow-up
and the
biopsy.
MRI mammography that you were saying, even that I have spoken about in the last slide, that it should be done.
Okay.
It was not done in this study because we had some patients from the lower socioeconomic strata.
So how long the total
study
was? 6 months.
6 months.
So are you still following those patients? For 6 months
yes,
per
yes,
year?
Yes,
okay.
Yes.
So how much time is total now you've been following this patient?
Around 20 months.
20 months, okay. Thank you.
They're doing good.
Thank you.
Dr. Sandeep, thank you for the presentation. I would like to know which schedule of Mr. Do strategy to use in those patients.
Well, if Mr. Andreas says, I can say that I had used Elixir. Where is he? He's not here. It was Elixir.
But which kind of
A? A. Elixir A in an A? Ascending dosage. Starting from 1 milligram to, I think, 50.
Okay, and how many days per week?
Three days. Alternate day, each series pack has 7 ampules, right? So after 2 packs, that is 14, 28 days. After that, you give a break of a few days. Well, it depends. A few people advocate a 14 days gap before starting the next series. Sometimes I prefer 2 days, sometimes I prefer 10, depending on the condition of the patient.
Thank you.
So, any other question? This will be the last question.
Question on the breast cancer statistics you mentioned earlier. Why the higher incidence? What is the prevailing thought in India?
The population of Europe is 740 million. The population of India is 1.25 billion.
It was not per capita statistically. It's just the number, total.
The number.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. I thought it was per capita. Thank you.